Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. We are alhamdulillah on the fourth five ayat from Surah Qaf. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ وَنَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying in this ayat, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ. We indeed, when you see لَقَدْ means usually indeed, verily, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ. We created man. He said, Subhanahu wa na'lamu ma tuwaswisu bihi nafsuh. And we know what yourself whispers to you. And conclude this ayah, wa nahnu aqrabu ilayhi min hablil warid. And we are closer to him than his jugular vein. Subhanallah, in this ayah, there are three attributes to Allah. First of all, creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us that I have created you. And obviously, who creates you knows best about you. أَلَا يَعْلَوْ مَنْ خَلَقَ وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ. Doesn't know who created you, what he's doing for you. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ. Then, وَنَحْنُ أَعْلَمُ وَنَحْنُ نَعْلَمُ مَا تُوَسْوِسُ بِهِ نَفْسُهُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows exactly what the internal discussion behind your heart, what is going on. Sometimes you state it, sometimes you don't. Status sometimes even you try to conceal it behind yourself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows all of them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concluded this ayah with saying, وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ. We are very close to you. From all of these attributes, a person must submit completely to Allah, who creates, who knows, who is closer to you. وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala direct our attention to the reality of life. During this journey in life, إِذْ يَتَلَقَّ الْمُتَلَقِّيَانِ. Is when, but it means continuously. إِذْ يَتَلَقَّى. يَتَلَقَّى receives. المتلقيان receptors or receivers. Referring, all scholars said that this ayah refers to the two angels, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala assigned to them the task of recording what you do, what you say during the whole journey of life. إِذْ يَتَلَقَّى الْمُتَلَقِّيَانِ عَنِ الْيَمِينِ on your right and عَنِ الشِّمَالِ in your left قَعِيد. They are watching completely. They are not absent. They are close to you. In one hadith, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, be careful, be considerate to those who are with you. Now, the Creator tells you that I appointed two witness on your shoulders. Hadith Rasulullah said, be considerate to those who are with you. They are with you. You are moving in this life, wherever, whenever, they are with you. And the following ayah saying, مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رقيب عتيد. You have never utter يلفظ من قول saying and saying not only by word. When you say something, you know, subhanallah, for some reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said قول saying. This saying can be made by word, my body language, or even in social media, you do just like or dislike, whatever, emotions. All of them, ما يلفظ من قبل, because all of them under saying, you say something. You have never say anything unless you have in front of you, before you, رقيب. رقيب, from the word رقيب, رقب, يرقب, means watching. And عتيد, very strong. Nothing escape from his watching. If you remember hadith سيدة عائشة رضي الله عنها, when she said one day, I mentioned صفية, another wife of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but I refer to her as by my handis, by that is she is so short. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told her immediately that Aisha, you say something, if we take it and put it on the sea, it will change its color, its taste. She doesn't say anything. She doesn't move her lips, but just refer by her hand. That's why it is very serious when you say something. Be careful about yourself before others, because it will be recorded and presented on that day for or you or against you. ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد. Then this five ayat concluded with وجاءت سكرة الموت بالحق. The death comes to you. وجاءت, and the word جاءت is in the formula of the past tense. Even it will coming to you, but it is done, means that it is just a matter of time. وَجَاءَتْ سَكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ. The trance of death will bring the truth. The death will come with the truth. Because what happens after the death is the complete truth. No one can deny. Now we have option to believe or not to believe. But after, there is no option. وَجَاءَ السَّكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ. This death will come with the truth. So we have to prepare to that moment and to prepare ourselves for what is coming after that death. Remember that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it is narrated that النَّاسُ نِيَامُ إِذَا مَاتُوا انْتَبَهُوا. People are asleep. When they die, they will wake up. So we have to wake ourselves now to be prepared for that moment, because it will bring the truth. وَجَاءَ السَّكْرَةُ الْمَوْتِ بِالْحَقِّ. ذَلِكَ, this death, مَا كُنْتَ مِنْهُ تَحِيدُ. You try, or the whole journey of life, you try to escape from this death, but now no escape. Subhanallah, sometimes he survived from this accident. Are you sure? Yes, he survived from this accident, but he will not survive forever. One day he will be caught by this death. And Subhanallah, this Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressing you. ذَلِكَ مَا كُنْتَ. Every one of us, everyone tries hard from the creation, from the birthday until the last moment, try to escape from death. But when it comes, it comes. Tahid, escape, avoid it. And subhanallah, وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْوَعِيدِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on that day, the day of wa'id. Wa'id means the promise, but usually promise with punishment. On that day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will order the angel to blow that sound. So everyone will hear it and wake up. وَنُفِخَ فِي الصُّورِ. Blow that trumpet. Everyone will awake. Everyone will be awake to receive their recording log, what they have done in this dunya. This is kind, this is just one item of the creed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keeps telling us to prepare ourselves on that day. And that's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, every Friday, every congregation remind believers about these basic facts which we always try to forget. And when anyone remind us of death and it is truth, we don't like this conversation. We need it to correct ourselves. We need it to amend our mistakes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable our hearts to receive the guidance from Allah and act upon this truth. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.